I am a champion. Where is he? I said, where is he? I'll be a winner with distinction. I can't hear you. You stand like a winner. Stand like a champion. Because this day I'm transferring something to that heart of yours. You'll get it in Jesus' name. I'm sure you are a champion. You are a winner with distinction in Jesus' name. Raise up those hands of yours. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this hour and this day. We thank you, Lord, we have here champions, men and women in the making in Jesus' name. And I pray that the spirit of championship will come into everyone. Success, promotion, intelligence, understanding, salvation, holiness, healing, power, authority, until they rise beyond the starry skies. Do it in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, I pray that you lay your hand upon everyone. No sickness to hinder you. No oppression to attack you. And nothing of the devil to stop your way to championship in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray for mothers and fathers here too. Oh Lord, I pray with you will pick it up. We'll all be champions in our families in Jesus' name. Daddy, a champion. Mommy, a champion. Brothers and sisters, champion. And these are victorious youth, champions in Jesus' name. Confirm each in every life. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody, everybody, everywhere said, amen. Thank you very much. You can be seated. We're looking at someone. In Psalm 1, verses 1, 2, 3. Young people, do you have your Bible here? Where's your Bible? Wonderful. That's the roadmap to success and championship. You got it already. Psalm 1, I'm reading from verse 1. Blessed is the boy. Blessed is the girl. Blessed is the one. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of discomfort. But his delight, her delight, is in the law of the Lord. And in his law, in God's own law, does he meditate day and night. He shall be, I will be. He shall be, you will be. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. You are fruitful. Amen. His leaf also shall not wither. And whatsoever, young people, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Whatever I do will prosper. Whatever you do will prosper. In the school, you will prosper. In college, you'll prosper. In your profession, you'll prosper. In the ministry, you will prosper. Everywhere you go, prosperity. I said prosperity and promotion will be waiting for you in Jesus' name. And whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. I'm speaking to you on the signposts on the road to championship. Signposts on the road to championship. How does that start? How do we have championship and success and victory? It doesn't start from the external. You see, there are people that are thinking, I want to be a champion if somebody will encourage me. I want to be a champion if somebody will give me a helping hand. They don't know what we call self-reliance. They don't know what we call savior reliance. They don't know what we call spirit reliance. That you understand with you and God, you are the majority. And with you and Christ, you're already a winner. And you'll be a winner in Jesus' name. And so how does this spirit of championship, how does it start? Because it says now, you're going to be a champion whatsoever he doeth, tell me again, shall prosper. You'll prosper in Jesus' name. Number one, desire. There must be something inside you. There must be something inside you that is saying, that's what I want, that's what I'm going to be. And then you set yourself, your scale high, your goal very high. You're looking at the horizon in my chosen field, in my area. That's where I'm going, that's what I'm who I'm getting to, and you will get there. But you see, it starts from within. It's an internal thing. The motivation is inside you. The zeal is inside you. The passion is inside you. The excitement to be a champion is inside you. And the vision is inside your heart. Therefore, number one is, tell me out aloud, desire. I'm looking at Psalm 37. I'm reading from verse 3 here. It says in Psalm 37, verse 3, it says, trust in the Lord and do good, so shalt thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. Hunger will not kill you. Famine will not come your way. And your need will be supplied in Jesus' name. Now delight thyself also in the Lord. Be born again. Be a child of God. Let Christ live on the inside of you. And everywhere you go, you carry Jesus about. You're a Jesus boy. You're a Jesus girl. I'm a Jesus girl. Tell me that. Anywhere you go, and when they say hi about this side, you say, no, champions don't do something like that. And then they're discussing, they're wasting their lives and wasting their time, and they're into this, into that. Say, champions don't get involved like that. You pass them by. I said, you are going to pass them by. There is a desire inside you. You desire the Lord. Look at verse 4. It says, delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee what? The desires of thine heart. Praise the Lord, it is done. The desires of thine, commit thy way unto the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. It will happen. I said it will happen. And well, very soon I'll see you on that mountaintop. On that peak, and then eventually as you go up and up, higher and higher, you know, a few years, next night when I meet you, I'll say, Pastor, I was the one you were talking to that day, and you showed me, and I got it. I said, I got it. The signpost to the on the road of championship, and then you tell me, I am here now. Then you say, Pastor, but I'm not through yet. I'm still going. Tell me out loud. I'm still going where? Higher, higher and higher you will go in Jesus' name. Number one, desire. Number two, decision. Decision. You see, there are many people, they're always at the corridor of desire. And they're always saying, I will. And they never get up to do something. I will. They never actually decide that this is what I'm going to do. But the people that put some action into their desire, they put some performance into their desire. They put some activity into their desire. They put some study time into their desire. They put some a kind of discipline. They discipline themselves and screw themselves and say, I'm getting up here. I'm not going to be where I was last time. I'm getting higher. And then they get up and they take the first step and the second step and the first step and the second step. And then they are going. It's the people on the go who are moving. And they have decided, I'm going to do something. Those are the people that make it. You'll make it in Jesus' name. I said number two is, tell me the word decision. Look at this in Psalm 57. I'm reading from verse 1. Psalm 57, and I'm reading here from verse 1. Psalm 57 verse 1. Look at this and mark it your Bible. It says in Psalm 57 verse 7, my heart is fixed, O God, my heart is fixed. There's a boy that has decision. My heart is fixed, oh God. My heart is fixed. There's a girl that has decision. My heart is fixed, oh God. My heart is fixed. You see, there are some people that are wishy-washy. Any kind of wind will blow them. Any friend will drag them to something else. They do not have a real decision. A decision that stands. A decision that said, this is where I'm going. Another friend comes and he says, would you go this other? He says, no, I've made up my heart. It's fixed, oh God. My heart is fixed. And you make up your mind, this is the way to go, and I'm getting there. I said, I'm getting there. When I make up my mind, I'm now on the road to championship. And already I have that desire. And there's nothing to stop that desire. And then I'm saying, this is this. I've made up my mind. And I'm going to get there. It doesn't matter what difficulties are there on the way. It doesn't matter what challenges I face. It doesn't matter the heat of the day. It doesn't matter the opposition. It doesn't matter the slander. I am getting there. We're getting there together in Jesus' name. My heart is fixed. Oh God, tell me. My heart is fixed. I'm looking at Psalm 108, and I'm reading here from verse 1. Psalm 108, verse 1. It says, oh God, my heart is fixed. Look at this man. He said it before, and maybe Satan did not hear. Maybe the demons did not hear. Maybe the friends did not hear. Or maybe he himself, he has not gathered himself together. He has not put all the flabby areas of his life together. He has not collated everything, every area together. He has not planned very well. And he reassured himself again. And he said it to God in prayer and commitment. Oh God, my heart is fixed. Psalm 112. I'm looking at verse 7 here. He shall not be afraid of evil tidings. His heart is fixed, trusting in the Lord. He shall not be afraid of, they say that, you know, that course is difficult, that place is a challenge, and those who go to that position, they never make it. They say that if you are from this area of the country, then if you go to that other area to study, they discriminate against them, and therefore they are not able to. They say that when you go there, if you are not able to give the lecturers and the teachers and this and that, give them this and give them that, that you'll not make it. You say, for me, I'm going to scale through. I said I'm going to scale through. They have not made that hindrance for the person that has decision. They have not made that hindrance for that person that has the heart to rise. They have not made any of those hindrances that will stop that man, that will stop that boy, or stop that girl. Nothing will stop you in Jesus' name. See, for the third time that he says he's not afraid of evil tidings, his heart is, tell me, fixed, trusting in the Lord. Number one is desire. Number two is decision. Number three is deliverance. Deliverance. You see, sometimes we want to rise. And there's something coming from our background. It may be from our family. It may be from, you know, ourselves. Maybe some mistakes we had made or some involvement we got in because ignorantly. When you got to maybe even primary school, some people introduce some things to you, and then you found yourself, you know, in some areas of darkness, and you say, what is this? By the time you get to secondary school, it's like, you know, this and that. And even though you want to rise, and I know you are going to rise. I said you are going to rise, but there is that involvement with occultism, involvement with a gang, involvement with drugs, involvement with this and that, that is giving you a setback. I say, what am I going to do now? Because I have the vision, I have the desire, I have everything, but you know, this is setting me back. I come to tell you this morning that before we're through, I'll break that yoke. There's an anointing here this morning. It will break every yoke in your life in Jesus' name. It doesn't matter the power on the opposite side. I'm getting rid of that this morning. I'm just going to release you to soar high. I'm going to release you to get to the place you ought to get to. That's why I come with number three. Tell me again. Tell me out loud. I'm looking at Psalm 40. We're looking at Psalm 40 verse 17. Psalm 40 verse 17. But I am poor and needy, yet the Lord thinketh upon me. Thou art my help and my deliverer. Thou art my help and what? And my deliverer. Tell me out loud, that my help and deliverer. Won't you go, all the youth? Won't you go? Tell me assuredly. Tell me with conviction. Help is coming. Help is coming. Financial help is coming. Educational help is coming. Scholarship help is coming. Human help is coming. Mental, educational help. Everything is coming in Jesus' name. Help is coming my way. So somebody said, I don't have this. I said, but help is coming. And they say, I don't have this. I said, help is coming. In this area, I say, what's coming? Help. Health is coming. Help is coming. It's coming my way. Coming your way in Jesus' name. It says, help, thou art my help and deliverer. Deliverer has come also. Deliverance has come also. And then it says in that verse 17, make no tarrying, oh my God. I'm such in a hurry. I want to get there in good time. Let there be deliverance immediately now. It is coming. It has come in Jesus' name. Number one, give me number one. Give me number two. Give me number three. Number four is departure. Departure. Number four is departure. I'm reading here from Psalm 34. Psalm 34. Give me this word, number four now. Tell me out loud, out loud. Departure, departure. I'm looking at Psalm 34, Psalm 34. I read from verse 11. I'm actually going to verse 14, but I'm starting from verse 11. It says, come, ye children. And it says, hearken unto me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. I'll teach you how to get there. I said I'll teach you how to get there. But the point is, I want to use you as a point of contact to raise champions through you. I said I'm raising champions through you. Because it's all over this land in Nigeria, all over this continent of Africa and beyond Africa. I'm going to make you the number one here. If necessary, in fact, you know, I'll tell you a lot of things we're still going to do. If we can work together, I said if we can work together, we'll lift up even this nation and this continent, we'll lift it higher in Jesus' name. And you know, I'll be telling you the programs we're going to have. And you know, when all our mothers and fathers say, mommy, daddy, you can stay at home, we're going to be with champion number one. I said we're going to be with champion number one. Point to champion number one. Praise the Lord, I am. And then I take your hand. I say, where do you want to go? Tell me your dream. Tell me your desire. Tell me where you are going. Then I hold onto your hand. And then I say, put your leg here. Put your leg here. Put your leg here. Before you know what, you are there already. Jesus' name. And so when I announce all those things that we all come over here, or I take you to DLCC, whatever title we give that thing, I'm going to wash off everything out of your life. And then by the time you get back to school, get back to college, champion. I said champion. And then through you, we'll raise champions in all the continent of Africa and beyond. It is going to happen in Jesus' name. That's why it says in verse 11, it says, come ye children, hearken unto me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. What man, what boy, what girl is he that desireth life and loveth to see many days, that he may see good? That's you right there. It says, keep thy tongue from evil and thy lips from speaking guile. Tell me now the first word in verse 14. Tell me loud in verse 14. Shout it out to me, verse 14. It says, depart from evil and do good. Depart from evil and do good and seek peace and pursue it. That's why I said that is departure. Now, number five is devotion. Devotion. You see, there are some people, they have a good intention, they have a good desire, but there's no devotion, there's no concentration. For a person to have to get all his heart, all his mind, all his concentration, all his brain, everything he's got into just this one thing. You know, if you don't suppose you are doing a science or you've been in a physics class, and they take that prism, that block of glass that is a kind of triangle, you know what I'm talking about? And then you come outside, you put a sheet of paper down, and then you put that prism on that sheet of paper, and all the rays of light coming from every direction, they center on one point. What will they do to that paper? We'll burn it up. That's the power of concentration. When a person says, this one thing I'm devoted to. People go here, this one thing I'm devoted to. People want to break rules in school. They want to go here, go there. This one thing I'm committed to. People want to go to a nightclub. This one thing I'm committed to. And people want to experiment with drugs and, you know, whatever it is, and he says, this one thing I'm committed to. They want to experiment with this. It says, this one. Devotion. When that devotion is your life, and you are a boy, a girl of just one thing, this is the real thing now. This is the focus now. This is what I put my attention to now. It will not be long. I'll find you. You'll be a champion. Yeah. I said, you'll be a champion. Yeah. Psalm 119. I'm reading here from verse 37. Psalm 119, verse 37. It says, turn away mine eyes from beholding vanity, and quicken thou me in thy way. Establish thy word unto thy servant who is devoted, who is devoted, who is devoted to thy fear. It says that just one thing I concentrate on. I maximize my intelligence, the result of my intelligence, and I focus on just that one thing. I do it now, I do it now, I do it now, I do it again. You will succeed. I said you will succeed. That's devotion. Number six is daily duty. Daily duty, daily duty. You see, there are some people, they allow, sometimes, you know, all these vacations that were given, sometimes vacation is good physically, sometimes vacation is, it has a negative result. We'll be studying and going to class. Number one, you go on Monday and Tuesday and Wednesday and Thursday and Friday. And then when Friday comes, it's like some young people say, praise the Lord, this is Friday, and I can be free from all this now. And for the next 48 hours, they don't see the page of any book. For the next 48 hours, they do not understand. We don't get vacation like that. You make your body to rest, but your brain must keep working. And then you look over that thing again. Look over that. It's a daily duty. Other people, after we have, you know, we've done about a term or semester, and then they say they now give us vacation, and then we can go for 2 months, and then we go for 3 months. All the 3 months, we don't open the page of any book at all. It's just like, brain is on vacation, mind on vacation, body on vacation. All we're to do now is only eat and sleep, only eat and sleep for 3 months. By the time we come back after 3 months, the brain is empty, the body is full, because too much food and there's no knowledge, because we didn't understand that all during that vacation, I keep on doing that thing. I say I keep on doing that thing. I say I keep on doing that thing. It's a daily duty that gets me to the top. That's what will get you to the top in Jesus' name. It will be done. I said it will be done. You are getting quiet on me. I said it will be done. But looking at Psalm 61, I'm reading 2 verses there, but I'll read verse 2. After that, I'll go to the final verse there. Look at Psalm 61. You must not miss this one. Psalm 61, verse 2. From the end of the earth will I cry unto thee. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me, tell me. Lead me, tell me everything. Lead me to where? To the rock that is higher than I. Whatever goals I've set, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. It's okay about the Lord Jesus Christ was still to come. And then when I get him, he is the greatest champion that ever lived. He's the son of David. And even though David was a champion, but Jesus Christ, the son of David, he conquered death. He conquered the grave. He conquered circumstances. He conquered the waves. He conquered sickness. He conquered demons. He conquered Satan. And he said, it is finished. And that is the rock of ages cleft for me. Let me hide myself in thee. Let the water and the blood from your wounded side will flow. Be of a cure. And give me a double cure. And he says, when I hide in him, he will lead me to the rock that is higher than I. He will do that in Jesus' name. How will that happen? Look at verse 8. So will I sing praise unto thee, unto thy name forever, that I may daily perform my vows, that I may daily perform my decisions, that I may daily do something to contribute to where I am going. Let every day contribute to that higher place you are going, to that championship where you are going. You'll get there in Jesus' name. Now it says, number one is desire. Number two, give it to me. Number three, tell me. Number four. Number five. Number six. Daily duty. Will you do that? I said, will you do that? And you know, sometimes when we were a little bit tired and sick, maybe it's malaria or whatever, and then mommy or daddy takes us to the doctor, and the doctor says, here is something that I'm going to give to you. These are pills, and you take this in the morning, you take this in the afternoon, take this in the evening, you hear, say, yes, sir. And then you get everything, you put it there, and then mommy said, what did the doctor say? That is, mommy's doctor said, I should take this in the morning, and then tell me, take this in the afternoon, and then tell me the next one, take this in the evening, and only at 6 hours something, you know, at 8 o'clock, and then at 2 o'clock, and then at 8 o'clock, and then for the day that's all, and the following day you do that. But if you do that consistently and you do that for 3 days, you'll be all right. I will be all right. I said I'll be all right. I said I'll be all right. And then you take it, and then the first morning, 8 o'clock, mommy said, do you remember? Yes, mommy, I remember. And then you take that, and then 2 o'clock, I've forgotten. 8 o'clock in the night, I forgot. And then the following morning, mommy saw that everything was all right, and the following day, I forgot it. And then the third day, and the doctor said, you know, by the third day, everything will be all right. And look at, and then I read, oh, 2 o'clock on the third day. I then quickly go there, and I put something there. And then third day, I'm still not all right. Look at what the doctor said. The doctor said I'll be all right at the end of 3 days, and I'm not all right. Is it doctor's fault? Whose fault is this? It's my fault, but this fault, I'm going to cure it this 2013. Because if I do this, the desire, the decision, the deliverance, the departure, the devotion, and the daily duty, I'm telling you, I'm going to get there. I said I'm going to get there. And it's not just that, you know, the pastor said I'm getting there. And then only today, then you are very, very soon. Then tomorrow, Monday, you brush up everything. And then mommy said, hey, where are you, so and so? I am reading. Daddy, and the pastor said, championship, championship. And then that's Monday. And then Tuesday, the book is, we don't open the book again. And then Wednesday, Thursday, then football and, you know, television and this and that. And then at the end of the session, I see you. Pastor, I don't understand this. You said we're champions, but look at what I got. Whose fault? Pastor's fault? Whose fault is that? We're going to clear that thing away. I said we'll clear that thing away. It is done in Jesus' name. Let's look at this Psalm 8. Looks like the psalmist has a lot to say about becoming a champion. He was a champion himself. That's why he has a lot to say. We're looking at Psalm 8. I'm reading from verse 4. Psalm 8, verse 4. What is man that thou art mindful of him? Or the son of man that thou visitest him? For thou hast made him only a little lower than angels. Give me a good amen. Amen. Then it says, and you have crowned him with glory and honor, and has made him to have, and has made him to have, and has made him to have dominion over the works of thy hand. What do you see there? Over the works, dominion over the works of thy hand. You know, all the people that do geology and they examine all these stratas of rocks and everything, that's the work of the hand of the Lord, but they have dominion over them. All the people that study zoology and they study all these animals and they can tell us this and all that, they have dominion over that area. All the people that are studying the birds and they can tell all the characteristics and all the things of this and this, and they can even learn about, you know, the aviation and everything from the character of those birds. It's made, they have dominion over the works of his hand. All the people that go into the sea and then they study all these things, and then by the time they go research, they do all the research and they bring out all this, they have dominion over the works of his hand. All the people that do space science, and then all these rockets and jets and everything there, they have dominion over everything. And then we take the work of the creation, the crown of creation, that is man now, and then we look at the anatomy, we look at the body and everything, and then they're able to tell us how many bones you have there, when something is wrong with your hand, when something wrong with your skin or with your hair falling off, they had dominion over the works of his hand. All the people that are doing all this building, architecture, and then they know that if you take this kind of material and this and that, you can build this. They have dominion over the works of his hand. Any profession you are talking about, the Lord says he has made all the creation. And then he's giving us now, if you will follow all this, whichever area you follow in all these studies, dominion. I said dominion. It says, thou madest him to have dominion over the works of thy hand, and thou hast put all things under his feet. Thou hast put all things under his feet. I said, thou hast put all things under his feet. Sickness under my feet. Demons under my feet. Affliction under my feet. Failure under my feet. Harassment under my feet. Dejection under my feet. Poverty under my feet. Brain problem under my feet. And you know, I didn't say under your buttocks. I said under your feet. I said under your feet. Under my feet. Under my feet. Under my feet. What are problems? What are the demons? What are the challenges? What is failure? What is it? I can't see it. Demonstrate it to me. You got it, you got it in Jesus' name. You will excel. I said you will excel. That championship you are getting there in Jesus' name. Open your mouth and tell the Lord, and then I'm going to confirm everything you say in prayer. You tell the Lord, you tell the Lord, I'll show the signpost on the road to championship. The signpost on the road to championship. We're getting there. We're getting there. We're getting there. Everything now is under your feet. You have dominion, dominion, dominion. You have that victory in Jesus' name. Tell the Lord. Tell the Lord. It's happening. It's happening. It's happening. You're going to get it. It's yours. It's yours. This is your birthright. These are the gifts the Lord is giving to you. Dominion and victory and success. You are now on your way, on your road to championship. You're on your way. You'll get there. You'll get there. It's giving us dominion. In Jesus' name we pray. Victorious youth of this generation, in Jesus' name we pray. Raise up those hands. As high as you want to go. As high as you want to go. As high as you want to go. You are going higher. Yeah. I said you are going higher. Yeah. There is no hindrance in your way. Breakthrough has come. Yeah. Victory has come. Yeah. Deliverance has come. Yeah. Dominion has come. Yeah. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for every boy, every girl here. I thank you, Lord, because you have planted something now in every heart. And I know they're going to the top and they're getting there in Jesus' name. Of all the young people here and those who are connected with us now, they're connected with victory. They're connected with power. They're connected with authority. And they're connected with dominion. I pray, oh Lord, put your dominion, your power in every life in Jesus' name. Sickness, come under their feet. Affliction, come under their feet. Failure, come under their feet. The feet, come under their feet. All those demon powers and all those occultic powers, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, I pray that your spirit will inhabit, will indwell every boy, every girl, and the spirit to conquer, and the spirit to be victorious, and the spirit to move on until they get to the starry skies. Give unto them in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, I pray. You said, whatever they do will prosper. Whatever subject, whatever profession, whatever area, I'm asking, oh Lord, for every boy, every girl here, I'm asking that success and that prosperity will come to everyone in Jesus' name. I clear the way before you. I clear the way before you. All hindrances are taken away before you. You get up now. You get up now with a real desire. You get up now with a real decision. You get up right now. There's deliverance for you already. And then you depart from evil and you are devoted totally to the Lord. Daily, 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 you become higher and higher and higher and higher until you have total dominion in Jesus' name. Father, confirm it for every child here. And for mommy and daddy, for our fathers and mothers, confirm it, oh Lord, in Jesus' name. We thank you, we thank you, we worship you, praise you, because we know it is done. In Jesus' name we pray. And the victorious you said, and the champions of the hour, the champions of the day, the champions of this country, and the champions of the continent say, Amen.